Starting lineups. And guys, taking a look at Tabo Cephalosha, what will we see from him?
You know, every team needs a stopper out on the perimeter, Kevin. There's so many great offensive players in this league, so you've got to have a guy who can shut people down. That's what Cephalosha does. He's savvy, he's long-armed, he's quick laterally, and he knows how to defend.
Yeah, one thing that Tabo always had is that defensive calling card, guys, that great defensive presence. It isn't easy finding guys out on the perimeter play like him. And this team is lucky to have him, getting his hands in passing lanes, deflecting passes, always around the ball, lockdown defense, invaluable play for the Oklahoma City Thunder. They come in off a loss to Miami. And so off the tip, it's New York. Felton dishes to Shumpert. Chandler with the screen on Durant. A drive by Shumpert. The timely screen gave him a step, and he took it all the way.
Tyson Chandler, first-time All-Star last season. His 12th season in the league. This is a guy that came right out of high school. It was a long time coming for him, but certainly that All-Star berth well-deserved.
Now here's Jackson. Ibaka sets the pick for Durant. From the wing, it's hauled in by Felton. Upside, Felton. Anthony left side, trying to find Chandler. He's got it now, and that one's good. And for Tyson Chandler, it's been a long road over the last few seasons. Steve, he's playing undoubtedly the best basketball of his career.
Yeah, a key contributor on Team USA, an NBA champion with the Mavericks in 2011, and now an NBA All-Star. It's the defense, it's the understanding of his teammates and the game plan. Just a very, very smart player and a hard worker as well. He's such a well-rounded offensive player. He's got a little bit of everything.
Here's Brigioni. Outside jumper. Pass to Anthony. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
You know, guys, Carmelo Anthony last year played pretty much full-time at the power forward position, and the results were excellent. I mean, he's got the strength to play inside, and when you look at what he does offensively, it creates a lot of matchup advantages for him and his team.
And you look at Carmelo, do you think, Steve, maybe the success that LeBron had going inside and playing the forward had any influence on Melo playing inside?
I think there's no doubt, Kevin. The league has gone smaller in a lot of ways. A lot of former three men are now becoming fours. The only way to do that, though, is if you have the strength to deal with bigger players, and Melo certainly has that strength.
The Thunder shooting their first shots from the stripe in this game.
Well, one of the better free throw shooting teams in the NBA. They're hitting about 80% from the line this year.
Yeah, guys, they can feel very good about themselves when you bring up those statistics. Impressive numbers. You know, with the recent success of Oklahoma City, you forget that in Kevin Durant's first season, they started out going 3-29. And I tell you what, you talk about their success, it's due to the resilience and perseverance and leadership of Kevin Durant and the rest of those guys.
The layup just gift wrapped right there. I mean, he had a clear path to the basket.
Now Jackson, averaging 13 points a contest. Ibaka with a screen on Felton. Jackson drives in. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Well, there is a culture of hard work, as Clark was talking about, and the perseverance for this Oklahoma City Thunder organization. Their star players, Steve, get a lot of credit, but it's the whole organization, don't you think?
No question. It's the culture that was set. Scott Brooks has continued to kind of establish that atmosphere in the locker room. And they have players who just want to work and want to get better. And when you have a large group of people all with that same approach, you're going to be very successful.
So for New York, their last game, a win against the Boston Celtics.
Yeah, guys, it was just their night. It seemed like they hit every shot they looked at.
Absolutely. It was just one of those games where the hot shooting of a couple of players eventually just infected everybody.
Now Jackson, after the missed three from Shumpert. To the wing on the left. Perkins against Chandler. They now take the lead.
tell you what, the post play has been rock solid right off the bat.
Well, that's the key to basketball. Get the ball inside, into the paint, either with a pass or with penetration.
Now, here's Felton looking for his first basket still in this one. Prigioni off a pick from Chandler. And Prigioni kicks to Anthony. Five to shoot. No good. Now Oklahoma City takes it the other way. They beat the Knicks during their last encounter in New York.
Yeah, they really had their number in that game. Big margin of victory for them. They got there by really including their bench. The depth became a major factor. They just wore them down.
And the Knicks decide to take their first time out here. What Steve just talked about regarding how much they spread their scoring around was probably the most striking thing about that big win.
And the fact that they did have such a huge lead allowed them to even use their bench a little more than normal, and that was something that served them well.
And the Thunder with some changes. Adams, he's checked in for Perkins. Collison comes in for Serge Ibaka, and Jeremy Lamb subbed in for Thabo Sefolosha. .103 left in the first quarter of the game. Felton kicks to Hardaway, feeds it to Tyler. Good, and the assist goes to Hardaway.
Nice pass. He got the ball right into his teammate's shooting pocket. On time and on target.
Pass to Lamb. Releases. They get the rebound. Fisher. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two.
Well, you don't win the amount of titles Derek Fisher has by standing around and letting your man do whatever he wants to do on D. Fisher is a wily veteran who anticipates plays. He's physical as a defender. And he knows how to take a charge, that's for sure.
Yeah, and that experience is Fisher's strength. He might not be as quick as he once was, or as, you know, as athletic as he probably once was when he joined the NBA with the Lakers. Makes up for it with a lot of his defensive smarts, his guy. And he sinks the second. Knicks trail by three. And there's the call on Derek Fisher. That's his first foul. Perry Jones, he's checked in for Kevin Durant. .41 seconds left here in the opening quarter. Inside, here's Hardaway, here's Tyler, and it's blocked by Adams. Smith for three. That's good. Smith's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game.
How in the world did they let him get that wide open?
Collison with a screen on Felton. Here's Fisher. And again, Oklahoma City, no good. New York's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Felton the pass to Carmelo. From past the arc. And Jones pulls it down. Fisher with the ball. And the release was before the buzzer, but it's off target. It's a tie game in New York. And the second quarter will get underway just after this short break. Tune in next Sunday. Welcome back to the NBA on 2K Sports. More action in store as the players get ready to go, having a nice break to get hydrated with Gatorade. And Steve and Clark and I are refreshed and ready to go here as well. And guys, what's your take on the Knicks so far?
It's been beautiful basketball to watch, guys. Really sharing and moving the ball. And as a result, they've got a great flow going.
Hand in glove, five guys working as one. The power of the fist, we call it. They've racked up a bunch of assists.
They've got Smith. Jeremy Tyler is out there with Anthony. Then there's Hardaway. Then it's Felton in at point guard. That's the five for New York right now. It's good, and the Thunder lead is cut to just 1 point on the basket from Anthony.
You know, one thing with Scott Brooks, guys, he's very consistent with his message. You listen in on those timeouts, it's all about getting stops. Defense, 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 and letting their offense come from that.
Fisher against Felton. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. That one's on Anthony. And Clark, you mentioned Brooks' single-mindedness. He stayed pretty constant with his rotations too.
And there's no doubt players appreciate knowing their role, but you know, a lot of critics have been surprised at how Brooks has stuck to his lineups. Some lineups that didn't seem to be all that effective. You know, his usual starting lineup with Cephalosha and Perkins on the floor hasn't been their best in terms of plus-minus, but Brooks very loyal to his starting group.
Catching up on the changes for Oklahoma City. Baca comes in for Adams. And Kevin Durant is subbed in for Jones. Oklahoma City trailer. It's Jackson with the drive. Good on the shot. Jackson's got his second bucket of the night.
Really tough to get that shot off with the size differential there. It's not an individual matchup he's going to win every time, especially in the post.
Very well done. I didn't think he had any business operating down there with the big fellas.
A shot by Smith. That one wide left.
There's no getting around the simple fact that that's a shot he has to knock down.
Stolen. And now the Knicks on the break. On up the court. And the shot is good. And the Knicks lead by one.
Three consecutive baskets have come right at the rim. The defense had better start buckling down and tightening up.
Yeah, they're getting exposed right now.
And Jackson gets it to go.
The lead changes hands once again. There has been no separation between these two teams tonight.
What an intriguing basketball game, that's for sure.
Here's Brigione. The dish to Smith. Smith missing again. And here is Cephalosha. In low to Ibaka. Soft touch off the glass. And it's a three-point Oklahoma City lead.
Oh, and their offense scorching now. Red hot. They've really turned it on.
I don't think they can play any better, guys. I mean, they are just making it look easy out there.
New York calls timeout.
It's one thing to intimidate with your play, and it's another to get in the face of a player's shot you just blocked. Last season, Ibaka took it to that next level and ruffled some feathers by doing just that.
Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
Yes, Kevin, during that break, Coach Scott Brooks had some words for his team. He said to his players, "We can do a lot of damage if we get more aggressive about driving the lane and taking it into the teeth of this defense." Something else he mentioned is that he's giving them the green light on offense. He wants to see a high volume of shots. Well, Coach, not wasting any time in tweaking the game plan. We'll see if it makes a difference as we approach halftime, Kevin.
Thank you, Doris. And speaking of Ibaka getting feisty, I remember seeing him get into it. In fact, with Coach Brooks, when he was subbed out of a game, there was that flagrant foul against Blake Griffin. He's got a fuse.
Well, he's showing a little bit of a hot-headed streak, Kevin. I like that. A little feistiness. I like that from your big men. You know, you want them to be tough.
Showing emotion.
Exactly.
Passion.
As long as you control the emotion.
Well said. And it's good.
He broke out the finger roll, guys. That was kind of a stylish finish.
For Oklahoma City, they've gotten four of the first five shots to fall in the second quarter. Outstanding shooting. Cephalosha dishes to Perkins. That's good. Perkins got the game tied up here for the Thunder.
The number of points they've scored in the paint already today is pretty eye-opening, Steve.
Oh, it's off the charts. It really is. And defensively, I mean, they have to start shutting down some of those lanes to the hoop.
Shumpert and the Knicks hit again from deep. Now it appears an injury out on the floor, and that does not look like any fun.
Yeah, he's not happy right now. You can see it's really hurting him.
Sure can, Steve. I mean, it's difficult to say exactly how serious it is, but hopefully we'll have an update soon.
Catching up on the changes for New York, Anthony comes in for Tyler. And it's Felton in for Shumpert. Jeremy Lamb's checked in for Oklahoma City.
That's one he knows he should have made.
Here's Felton out to Anthony. And stolen by Perkins. Here's Lamb. The shot from the low post is good. Lamb's got five.
I tell you what, the defenders didn't even get a sniff of him on that move to the hoop.
Here's Brigione. He's guarded by Lamb. And Brigione kicks to Chandler. And it's blocked by Lamb. Durant against Chandler. And And that one's good, Durant.
Well, I tell you what, I need to see some more assertiveness out of these defenders. They're not getting the job done.
Yeah, that's 10 of the last 12 points they've allowed on good looks right at the rim.
And Jackson with the block, and they'll keep possession. That's good. 20 seconds left in the second quarter. Kicks it to Lamb. Launches it. It's rebounded by New York. Anthony's got three rebounds now in this one. Following this one, they get to host the Cavaliers. And a tight game here as we end the first half. New York ahead, up by one. And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
Scott, and looking at the remainder of this basketball game, what are you asking from your group offensively?
Just keep moving the ball, keep tacking, don't hold the ball. You don't have a shot or a pass, you gotta drive it and kick it, drive it and kick it.
Coach, thank you so much. Guys, never good when the ball sticks.
All right, Doris, thank you. And folks, make sure to stay tuned in for halftime, and we'll be back right after that.
Now, presented by Sprint.
And it's a good one going out in New York. Glad to have you with us for our halftime show. The Knicks have been plugging away. If the playoffs started right now, they'd be on the outside looking in, but it could all change. A win here would move them into the eighth seed. Iman Shumpert not having much difficulty scoring against this Thunder defense. His range has been off the charts. 5 feet, 25 feet, there's no difference in the shot to him. The Pelicans will face off against the Timberwolves out in Minnesota. That's a game the home crowd is. LeBron James picked
the Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
Welcome back, everybody. The start of the second half getting underway. Both teams battling hard through the first half.
Really an extraordinary game for Shumpert. He's got 10 points, and he's got two baskets from out in three-point land.
I'm sure they'd like to get him a few more of those, so look for them to run some screens for him, try to pop him open.
Thunder shooting and offensive execution has been beyond great there. 63% from the floor in this game. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade for the second half of basketball. So the Thunder 5 right now. On the wings at Cephalosia and KD, Kevin Durant. Baca at the 4 with Perkins at the pivot. And it's Jackson in at the point guard position. Here's Felton after the made shot from Cephalosia. Felton the pass to Smith. He dishes it to Chandler. 6 to shoot. Felton against Jackson, and Jackson with the block. And now it's Cephalosia running. You can go all the way. The fast break ends at the rim with a jam.
Boy, the floor really opened up for him there.
It sure did. A good job getting it started before the defense can get itself set.
Jackson against Felton. Anthony kicks to Felton. Pass to Chandler. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him.
Well, guys, with the Knicks playing a space-the-floor, pick-and-roll offensive scheme, I mean, Tyson Chandler is a hand-in-glove fit as the high-flying finisher inside, keeping defenses honest and then cleaning up the mess on the weak side board if shots are missed.
And, Clark, you talked about what Chandler has meant for this Knicks team, both on the court and in the locker room, and you wonder, you know, if Dallas, Steve, had it to do over, do you think they would have tried harder to re-sign him?
Well, I understood the plan. Dallas felt like with Dirk Nowitzki getting older, they had to save that cap room for a superstar, maybe Dwight Howard or Chris Paul. But it's always easy in hindsight when those things don't happen to say, hey, what were you doing?
Time call here. The Knicks decide to talk it over.
Well, he's got to be disappointed with his team's play over the course of this run. And, thus the timeout. You got to talk things over, try to get back into the game.
Something has to change for them as they haven't looked good at all during this run. So a timeout is appropriate here.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Yes, Kevin, during that break, Coach Scott Brooks had some words for his team. He'd like them to better establish the transition game, to pick up the tempo and put pressure on the defense in the open floor. He also urged them to drive the lane aggressively on offense, saying they won't be able to handle us if we can get bodies to the basket each and every time down the court. Those are likely not the last adjustments they make today, guys. There's still time left in this one. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks, Doris. Moment here now for an injury report. And now Doris Burke has an update for us on Iman Shumpert. Doris, what's the news?
Guys, I had a moment to catch up with the Knicks head athletic trainer. Unfortunately, guys, he said it doesn't look good. An injury like this will keep him out the rest of the way tonight and for a while afterwards as well.
All right, Doris, thank you. And Steve and Clark, certainly not the news his fans were hoping for.
No, Kevin, it's, you know, guys, it's really too bad. Just a terribly unfortunate turn of events here.
Well, yeah, you hate to see that happen. And in the meantime, you know, his team now has to compensate for the loss. Let's see how they step up.
And there's another one for the Thunder.
You know, next time he has that much space, he should just go straight up with it and leave the fadeaway at home. Park that fadeaway and take the shot that's available.
Nice work to get inside and draw the foul.
Yeah, it's obvious. The defense not going to allow many easy layups. They're going to make you earn it from the line.
The Thunder shooting their seventh and eighth attempts at the foul line tonight.
Serge Ibaka, born and raised in the Republic of Congo. We've had African-born players in the league for decades, but it seems that as the league has reached out to develop talent there, the numbers are increasing from that part of the world.
Now, here's Felton, right now averaging 11 points a game. Smith for three. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. 1:56 left in the third. And that one's good from Fisher. And going back to Ibaka and the growing talent coming from the continent of Africa. Steve, 1 billion people there.
Soccer is still the biggest sport there, but steadily the NBA has made inroads at providing courts and equipment and coaching around the continent. So you would expect more and more players to come to the league from Africa.
Well, Bang and Bamute and Hashim Thabeet. Yep. I mean, they would get some notable players in the league from there. Nick Collison's checked in for the Thunder. Jeremy Lamb comes in for Cephalosha. Here's Oklahoma City now. They're on a 16-5 run here. Fisher dishes to Jones. And a miss there on the triple. Knicks trail by 10. Felton attacking. Outside Hardaway. Felton against Jones. Felton the pass to Hardaway. Got a piece of it off his foot. And they're saying he kicked the ball. We've got 1:08 left in the third quarter of the game. For the three. That's in there. Anthony with the assist. Anthony's got three assists now in this one.
You can't leave him alone, especially from long range.
The Thunder leading by 7. And Fisher kicks to Lamb. And right away, they match it with a three-pointer of their own. Lamb's got his third basket of the night right there. Hardaway is screened on Fisher. Anthony sets the pick for Felton. Outside Hardaway. This one for three. And the Knicks hit again from deep.
How about the response? Retaliation. Impressive, huh, guys?
I'll say exactly that as well. Nice job to recover those 3 points right away.
Fisher against Felton. For the three. Fisher can't hit. Knicks trail by 7. 4 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Smith dishes to Tyler. Smith the pass to Felton. Knocked loose. Now the fast break. Lamb with the ball. Throws it up high. Taken away by Anthony. And now the Knicks on the break. Jumps up. Hammers it home to polish off the break.
Boy, I love it. Active hands on the steal. Active feet on the fast break.
And Clark power on the dunk.
And guys, this is just too close of a game to be giving the ball up like that and then failing to get back in transition.
And as we end the third quarter, a great game. Both teams playing well. Thunder lead by 5. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter right here on 2K Sports.
Tune in this Friday.
And Steve, we've got a moment here to go to our State Farm assist of the game, coming on some very clever point guard play.
Well, he mans that position for a reason, Kevin, because he passes the ball so well, sets up his teammates beautifully, really gets this offense into a nice rhythm.
Delivering the pass important, but putting the pass in the right place for a shooter is, as you well know, huge.
Yep, no question.
Knicks trail by five. In the middle, it's Anthony and Chandler. Hardaway is out there with Pablo Prigioni, and it's Smith in at the three slot. That's the five for New York right now. Here's Prigioni out to Smith. Chandler dishes to Smith. Six to shoot. Here's Prigioni. No good on the three.
Nobody near him. He'll normally make that one.
Now here's Lamb. The three, and he gets it to go. Lamb's got the first basket as we get going in the fourth for the Thunder.
You might not think of him as a laser three-point shooter, but that shot was there for him, and he had to take it.
And Prigioni kicks to Hardaway. Shakes off the strong D and gets the bucket for two. Hardaway has got 12 points in just the second half. The Thunder leading by six. Jackson kicks to Perkins. Anthony against Durant. Here's Ibaka, and fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. Here's what the schedule says for the New York Knicks and what it looks like. Following this one, they get to host the Cavaliers.
Yeah, a lot of good matchups around the league. The one that I have my eye on is definitely the Miami Heat matchup.
The free throw drops from Ibaka. Thabo Sefolosha has checked in for Oklahoma City. Ibaka hits both of them.
They got to keep fighting their way to the line, guys. This half, it's been nothing but success for them there.
And their confidence has to just continue to go up the longer their perfection continues.
Knocked away. Here we go, one-on-one. Here's Jackson. And he gets it to go. And, guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for the Thunder.
Boy, their hounding, harassing effort at the defensive end, very impressive. And they forced quite a few turnovers as a result.
And another thing they're doing is really taking advantage of fast break opportunities, scoring some easy baskets.
New York calls timeout. Doris Burke has some information for us. Doris?
Yes, guys. Over that break, I was able to catch the message Mike Woodson was giving to his team. He is not pleased with the score and implored them to try to make a push right now, saying, "We don't have time, fellas. If we can't make a dent soon, I'll have to pull the plug." Pretty blunt, Kevin. Back to you.
New York, no good that time either.
You know, they're not totally dominating the glass, but they're definitely doing enough to keep this lead right where it is.
Well, if you're doing enough good things and you're maintaining at least a slight edge on the boards, you're usually going to be in pretty good shape.
Felton against Jackson. Felton kicks to Prigioni. Chandler right side. Anthony, the pass to Prigioni. There's the feed to Chandler. Oh, that's blocked. We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. Ibaka dishes to Jackson. His three-pointer's off the mark. Knicks trail by 12. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
They got to find something, you're right. Anthony down low, Ibaka on him. Lock at six. Right side, Felton. And the rebound goes to the Thunder. Jackson's got four rebounds now tonight. It's Durant on the wing. inside Jackson. Back to Durant. Chandler with the steal. Oh, and here comes Felton all alone. And the shot is good.
Nice, nice pass there. Good job to get it up quick.
The Thunder leading by 10. Jackson kicks to Durant. There's 1:38 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Lays it up and banks it in.
He shot the ball exceptionally well as they've built this lead for themselves here.
Outside, Felton. He feeds it to Chandler. And he gets it to go.
Another good pass, and their offensive execution has been impressive, to say the least.
The last four field goals have been assisted.
Yeah, passing has kept the defense off balance, but to get assist, you got to make the shots.
Hardaway's checked in for Smith. There's 1:26 left in the fourth. Here's Jackson. No good from outside. Knicks trail by 9. Outside Anthony. Banked in off the glass. 1:06 left to play here in the fourth. Outside Jackson. Durant, the pass to Ibaka. From the low block, shot is blocked, and it's going to be out of bounds. The Thunder will retain possession. And Oklahoma City making a change here. Adams checked in. Knocked away. Here's Jackson. Again, the miss by Jackson.
This quarter has not been his best. The defense may be starting to affect him a little bit.
He only dishes to Felton. Hardaway from outside. Kevin Durant with the rebound. The Thunder have gotten just under 45% of their attempts to drop in the fourth. 4 of 9. Outside Jackson. Shot clock at 6. Oklahoma City needs to get off a shot. Cephalosha misses.
He's always going to have a difficult time finishing when the defense is in his face like that.
And here's Anthony from the arc. Anthony missing again. Here's Jackson. It's off. So it's Oklahoma City picking up the win. It was a solid win, Clark.
Yeah, it was, and I think it came down to will more than skill. They went out and got this one.
Thank you for joining us for this presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports.